It burning the midnight oil. Dark out there. You know, we got the whole interior stripped out. I treated the front half of that rust up there. It's pretty bad. This actually looks really good compared to what it was. This was all a bear to get out. Anyway, it's about 1:30 in the morning, so this is as far as I'm going right now. Tomorrow's another day. The worst part is over here. Hard to see, but this bracket, there's a bracket here. I'll show you in the morning, I guess. Broke. But luckily, Amazon had it in stock, so these people, I mean, that's why they're taking over the world, right? Friday night, I break a very particular bracket for a 28-year-old car. You're gonna find it. Anyway, we'll start in the morning. See what we get. Alright, so here we are. This morning, I already treated this panel. As you can see, there's not too much rust. Taking out some cables. This took that out. That was actually live in the car. Not even taped off. Took the whole top off. I'm still not sure what I'm gonna do. The wheels have been changed. Had some ugly steel wheels. I treated this panel, but this one was pretty bad. Also, yesterday when taking out the seats, this bolt came out. I had to yank it out, but on a good note, that was actually a blessing because now I see that they go straight through. You can see today I'm gonna pressure wash them out of the car, so it'll probably come out better. So anyway, I'm about to clean it up. And I had taken the dash apart because yesterday this hinge had broken. Luckily for me, Amazon actually had the hinge. And I ordered it overnight. So that hinge right there, you can see it because I can't even see it. Here we are. This hinge really broke off. Anyway, these were monsters to take out these bolts, but they're out. So getting there. It's coming out pretty. I'm excited. It's promising. Back here, that bed looks beautiful, man. It's a shame. I'm gonna treat it. I'm still gonna hit it with undercoat armor there. So today, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna look for rust to see if it. But if it isn't too bad, I'm actually just gonna sand. And spot treat with primer instead so that I could do the undercoat, because otherwise I gotta wait 24 hours. Same thing with that over there. So let's see how it looks when we're done. Alright, here we are. About to take these bolts down. You see here? They're going on the other side already. I already brought up all that glue that they sealed this with, which caused this bracket to break. As you can see, it's ready to go. It's almost ready for vacuum. I got the doors off. Get in there. Clean this up, pressure washing, and figure out where we're at. Then I'll be back. So it's about 12 o'clock today, and just got that package. And I think this is the hinges. So, like I said, last night around 11 p.m., I ordered these. These are the hinges. That would be insane. They go right there. Remember, I told you I broke them before. All right, so let's see. Oh no. These are headlights. Wait a minute. So these are the headlights. What's this other package over here? I got way earlier. Earlier, I thought it was my headlights. Sorry, I'm freaking this camera all over the place. Wow, the hinges have been here. Wow, this came like at 10 o'clock this morning. Like I said, Amazon, game changer. Car customizers, that's serious right there. Anyway. The things I've done today, this is probably taking the most time. This is the seal that goes screwed on here, as you see. What was there is mostly in the garbage. I mean, it took a lot of hours to put on for $25 seal. This is usually what causes everything to leak. It has a little lip goes over the front of that to clear the hinge. Anyway. So here we go. Because Benny showed up, let me get that bolt off. Unfortunately, it's stripped. That's the worst thing that could happen. We got a couple of those bad boys. Look at this one. Look at that one. Yeah, didn't tell anybody. But here we are. I already scuffed the floor. I'm about to do the bed line in a second. Grateful for the help today. Got my niece inside right now. Playing Sims. I don't know if you can see her from here. Yeah, she's coming along. So should I pull the seats now? As you can see, they're filthy. This is what they look like right now. I mean, I already hit this one with the hose. That one I haven't hit at all, so you can see it really bad. My son's helping me today. Turn it off, my son. They're hitting this one. We've already hit it with soap and a pressure washer. So, open for our purple power with a mix of the turtle wax, I don't know where it is. And that, and I finished all the coating inside the Jeep now. Let it give it some time to dry, and we can move to the seal. But not bad. I originally had started with the can stuff, but didn't look right. Didn't look right. So other than that, I moved to the can stuff, which is, I don't even know where I put it. Anyway, it's around there. So anyway, stay tuned. Next update, my MVP's right here. My son figured out how to take the screws out. We're putting in the new brackets finally. We put this rubber seal. And yeah, I'm blessed. Thank you, Lord. Bumper, that thing was super duper duper heavy. As you can tell, it's really clean though. Look at that. It's like nice, compact, tight to the body. Also, we finished doing the Under Armour side. Left the center silver. Looks nice. Gotta clean, do a little cleanup. My son had a breakthrough. We took the speaker out. This thing killed us, bro. You don't ever want to have to take that speaker out. Ever in history. But
here's a magnet, bro.
We're almost done with that. So now it's drizzling. Hopefully we'll get that done. Anyway, so here we are. A couple days in. Drilling out the last of the bolts. These things are always a challenge. You know, not fun to do. So hopefully I'll get that out. And start to put this interior back together. So, new brackets. Anyway, stay tuned. It's been a little bit since I gave you guys an update. So I finished all of the rugs. They went in. No problem, as you can see. She came pretty good. Right now I got a mess in here. Putting together the putting the seats back in. So most of the bolts broke. But as you can see, it's a very nice finish. Not bad for $18 for what is it? 2 by 10 foot. The other thing I did was I finally cleaned up the steering wheel because it was really, really bad. Even, I know it looks bad now, but trust me, the dash has been reassembled. I'm gonna leave it for now. I saw this baking soda hack, which I'm gonna be messing with to repolish it at some point. But right now I wanna assemble it. The other thing I did was I kinda cleaned the steering wheel. Not kinda, I really cleaned it. I mean, I went in on it. I gotta get some sort of leather conditioner for it to get the leather back. And I cleaned all of the brackets. I got rid of the ugly GT sign there. But this was really, really bad. The other thing was the steering wheel was loose, and it turns out it was because the bracket that goes right here was not pointing up. So I'll be fixing that too. So yeah, she's coming along, as you can see. And stay tuned. She's coming out pretty good. So about to swap these pedals out. Let's shift lever. Normally I don't do the colorful stuff, but you know, it's gonna be better than that. Plus, I also did the center cover here. It's hard to see, but I'm gonna do something cleaner. Last night we had a massive downpour. Happy to report this tarp mostly held up. But yeah, so yesterday my day was a little bit slowed down between this bolt right here for the seat. Requires some extra reinforcement and yeah, it took a lot of my time. The other thing that zapped my time was the storm. So anyway, so I cleaned up the dash. It's a lot cleaner. And I cleaned up this steering wheel. Got rid of that ugly GT button. Also, you know, I'm not really into this typically, but, you know, I had to clean up those pedals. So it's a lot cleaner. I might color coordinate this thing. I'm debating whether to do something else with that. So we knocked out that. And yeah, we're still moving along. So hopefully today I'll be able to do the tune-up. And this morning, that's my plate down there. It's really tacky. Let me see if I make my own custom bracket. Anyway, all right, so here we are. I invented the holder there. It's pretty good. A little extra creative there. You can see the pedals went in, steering wheel, new shift knob. A lot cleaner than this hideous thing. I attempted to put the distributor on cap, but it didn't fit. It's different. In any case, I'm about to do the plugs now. I did a fresh oil change, left the dyno oil in there. I cleaned the filter, K&N style, and I put the new filter in. So yeah, see how this puppy runs afterwards. All right, so today I changed those components. Actually, now what I'm doing is the actual Lutter mod, which is emissions bypass. Being that this is over 25 years old, you can do this. At least that's what they've said. So I'm doing it now. Let's see how it comes out. I was definitely running way better, so I'm actually happy I did that. Anyway, stay tuned. So it's been a little while since I've given you guys an update. So I went ahead and went to Harbor Freight. Picked up a heat gun. It's your best friend for this job. And I'm taking off these Wrangler tires because, I mean, they're dated. I just don't like them. And I'm going to be replacing that with something else. Over the weekend, I went ahead and I put the antenna. I'm giving you guys an update. And so right now what I'm working on is debadging, taking this off, but I'm gonna be replacing it with something else. Also, I did the stubby antenna. Got that for $99 for like $13. To complete this job here, I went ahead and I used the heat gun at Harbor Freight. So it's coming out pretty good. I've done some other things. This weekend I finally did my center console, and we had this nice cooler at AutoZone for $8. I needed something waterproof that I could put in there. The big bulky thing had to go. So there's a little theme starting to show through by mistake, pretty much. This red gray theme. The other thing I did was I finally fixed my bikini top. So it was broken, and I'll show you guys that in more detail later. So stay tuned. I decided to do this turtle wax because I kind of love the car wash. Bought me this little $10 orbital polisher. So you can see, from faded to the difference, right? I'm sure the camera really does it justice, but anyway, stay tuned. Big difference from where I'm standing. Actually, see some shine on that thing. Look at that. To see in the dark, but give her a wax, got a good shine. Actually, the first time I've been motivated to bring her out. There we go. So, shine, put a rum on her, looking good. Put the decals on there, some consoles in, looking good. Little family ride for ice. Hey, so here we are. I'm about to do these lights here on my truck. Nothing else to do. No power in the house because, bam. Shitty, right? That's my power right there. Anyway, so back to this. Do these lights now. Here's the before. Can't wait to get rid of that ugly ass bumper too. All right, so here we are. Finished product. Cameras are in. Pretty good. big difference. Definitely didn't come with the bowls. I had to go pick these up at Napa Auto, you know, the little local shops. Only $2.50 compared to everybody else charging like 10 bucks for them. So anyway, it looks pretty cool.
Modern. Here we go.
Getting dark, so I'm gonna do my best here to demonstrate this. But for the sake of this, like I said, if you look at it, you see all that white. So I'm gonna start with a brand new, extra durable Mr. Clean. And I'm gonna use this CRC heavy duty pro shrink degreaser. So what I really like about this stuff is that for a degreaser, it foams up and it sticks, so I can actually control it. I don't really care that I'm getting it on the paint, because honestly, I'm gonna re-wax it. But you can even control the pour. So you see, you can go small if you wanted to. Anyway, so once you do that, it's really just gonna help with the lubricant. And here we go. All right, so I think that's pretty centered there. I've used some painter's tape to hold it down so I can go ahead and screw it in. I actually think it complements the Jeep well, especially with those lights in it. So we'll see it better during the day. Came with some instructions, some sheetrock style, not sheetrock, sheet metal style screws. So bolt it in, let's see what happens. All right, guys, so I wasn't planning on doing this today, but when I bought the Jeep, the guy who sold it to me told me that the one thing that it really needed was gonna be a card rebuild. And unfortunately, today I did another bypass. I've done a bunch of things to it. It's running really good. All of a sudden I put gas in it and I was running like crap. But anyway, yeah, so that's what I'm gonna spend my Sunday doing now. Luckily I bought the rebuild kit, so I have it. I'm not sure if it's gonna have those adaptive plates, gaskets. Anyway, so what I'm doing right now is just basically recording while I speak to you guys, all aspects of the carburetor for when I reassemble it. So yeah, I did it, guys. I have to close the carburetor. I'm gonna stop. Took it all apart. Give me a call to see if I do a review at some point. I got all my carb kits off of Amazon, and the instructions are non-existent, and there's nothing online. I'm taking the before picture of this, but in any case, when I took this all apart, that pan was really, I mean, it was like this, rusty. So what I did was I degreased it with some purple power, and then I used some coral seal. This stuff is great. And of course I applied it with that little brush that was at the screen. But anyway, what I'm doing is basically cleaning all these brackets. I'm taking advantage now while I got everything off. Truth of the matter is, we all know that none of us get back to things. So anyway, just wanted to show you that real quick. Hopefully it'll dry them up. Put this tube back in, and in the meantime, change those connectors. Hopefully that'll dry, and I'll show you the app. You can see by the date, 5/18/9/11. So definitely the sign. The other thing I'm doing is I'm putting these new posts on. Only $6. I got the black. They actually come with nice little felt pads and everything. And this is starting to finally heal. I don't know if I'm gonna before, because it's kind of getting dark. It's after 7 already. I'm trying my best to try to get the after shot here. But you can already see that all that, there was a very orange rust here, you know, like this. And that's what we get after. So anyway,
here you go.
Batteries installed, nice and clean. Everything's working. First time I turn her on, got the cars we did, the head, the valves, you name it. And as you can see, boom, oil pressure gauge is working. I basically brought these back to life. They've held up pretty well. Put a little armor on them, they look pretty good. But I got a good buddy of mine named Joe who actually recently gifted this to me, the Ultimate Black. He said he used it on his Jeep and it worked great. So I'm about to test it here, and I mean, preliminary, that looks really good. I mean, I don't think the video does it justice. There's a good comparison there. So, I mean, I'm sure it's more of a silicone type of thing, but allegedly it seals and lasts longer than just regular Armor All, which is what I've been using. So today I got a special guest over here helping me out. My son came over. He's gone ahead and pressure washed the crap out of this. And as you can see, he's working to get up the rust that's a little bit bad. But over here, as you can see, for the most part, the Jeep is clean. He's cleaned up a lot of it. So pretty soon we'll be able to treat all of this with rust converter. The other project that we're working on actually is his motorcycle over here. Figured out how the got the forks on finally, and figured out how that actually all mounts. So that'll be coming soon. Stay tuned. And it's fun, right?
Yeah.
Doing a good job down there. So we're basically treating it. We're using the rust converter right now. So earlier today, my son actually helped me pressure wash and clean the whole bottom, which is extremely important. You gotta degrease it. So, and right now what we're doing is just coating everything.
It might kill the Jeep.
So it won't kill the Jeep, right?
It won't kill the Jeep if we paint the grease.
The paint is actually gonna save the Jeep and convert all of this rust. So, you know, these just hitting everything up right now.
Actually, like painting the Jeep, but it's saving the life.
Exactly, painting the Jeep is saving the life. So, I got blessed today. I got my nephews here helping me out, and stay tuned, let's see how this thing comes out.
They helped me get all this done.
So as you can see, so this is the after. I'll show you the other side because I haven't finished this side yet. And that's what it looked like before. So that's not paint, that's actually that coral seal that it actually seals the converts, it's a rust converter. So it converts the rust into a different compound. Basically it's like a primer. And now after this, then I'm gonna hit it with bed liner. So stay tuned. All right, so some quick updates here. It's been a while since I recorded anything, but I'm kind of starting late. I don't even remember last minute because of I saw how far along I was. Anyway, so today I'm doing the shackles. So I'm doing rough country shackles there, and I ordered the bushings, but for whatever reason, that kit only comes with 12 bushings. They each go on each side. So I'm gonna be reusing the bottom ones there. And I'm putting the new ones up top. So anyway, but yeah, it's about an inch and a half difference. You can really tell here, as you can see, it's like a little subparish, and I cleaned it up with all the work I've been doing underneath it. So it's not that bad, pretty easy. Gotta put it on some jack stands back there. Unfortunately, this truck is pretty high, so I gotta put it on that wood.
Quick update, as you can see here, the front's been cleaned up a lot. I basically ordered this bumper here, AEM or something along those lines. You can see the difference back here. It's matching one, very clean. Got the tow hooks in. As you can see, a little bit of the before for the shackles. That's what it looks like now. So that's what I gotta do. Front, again, not too bad now. Kind of finding my way. But yeah, that's a big change there. As you can see, that shackle was very beefed up compared to the other one. Supposed to only give it an inch lift. I hope that's all it really does, because I'm not prepared for anything more than that.
Alrighty, so the upgraded shackles are in there. Came out pretty good, made a big difference. You can see they're a lot beefier. Nothing was bad to install. Definitely needed a jack to separate it from the frame. But yeah.
Here, so today I'm doing this transmission mount. As you can see, it is actually broken. I threw some degreaser on here because I'm gonna clean it, but if you look at this, see how it has that crack there? That's what that thumping sound's been. So it's not too bad. 6 screws on here, 1, 2, 3. Take this plate out, which I'll get to clean up. And then, I'm gonna clean this up here. I threw some degreaser on it. This crap. Just so that I get it all cleaned up while I'm under here. Treat all this rust as well while I'm at it. Put the new mount in and that's it, man. Put that, this is the trans mount. That's the stabilizer over there for the, it's called the, transfer case stabilizer, this or that or another. Anyway, so that thing right there. So I'm putting these two brand new. Right? Next. Talk to you soon.
Supposed to move like
it
or just make it tight?
Once it's tight all the way, it won't move anymore. Well, if you want me to check it, I can check it. Righty tighty, lefty loosey.
Like this way?
Mm-hmm. Alrighty, so here we are. So of all the things I've been dreading to deal with, it's actually been this right here. This little bit of rust situation. And it's not a lot in every spot, but it's enough for certain places, right? Like right here, for example. But I'm just saving the best for last, so. Recently, I ordered some touch-up paint to redo this right here. And as you can see, this was not the right color. So I emailed them eBay, Jesus. And they responded immediately, basically told me, apologize. They saw the problem. But all the things I've been dreading to do, this right here has been the one. This area here bubbling. And unfortunately, it has to be dealt with, you know? Either I deal with it or somebody else, but every time that it's not dealt with, it actually gets worse. So, I finally decided to take the plunge. I'm gonna go ahead and hit this with a Dremel and clean it up to the best of my ability and then touch it up one way or another. So, stay tuned, let's see how it comes out. I mean, it's a pretty wide surface, so I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get away with just regular touch-up. But you never know. All right, here we go. As you can see, all masked off. Use paper this time instead of the bag, which I think is better. So made it with a little bit of touch up. Let's see how she comes out. Thank you. So through process of elimination, this is the line. Not just because it's the longest one, but if you notice this junction, it has three hoses, three lines, I mean. And the other two, these actually turn this way. The only line I have that turns that way is the long one. But anyway, I recommend that as you're going through and removing this out of these, it's pretty snug. So you gotta put a little effort in. And as you remove the line, you wanna snake the other line up at the same time. So you wanna kind of do both as you go through. That way, you know exactly where it sits and you're kind of ensuring that you're not forcing or taking a different path up, because you have to follow the path to the tee. I went ahead and put the wire tie right there, as you can see it, making it really easy for me to identify the tube that needed to be replaced, which is this top one. So I'm removing it from here, from the master cylinder, from the, actually I think, believe this is the brake junction here for the lines. But in any case, you're gonna need a half inch wrench. And they saw these other ones that are kind of open-ended, they have the slit for the closed end to make it better, so that you don't strip the screw. But I don't own one of those, so it is what it is. The other thing you're gonna want to do is that I noticed quickly was I needed to secure the junction here, because what happens is this took a bit of effort. You can end up bending all this other thing and end up replacing a lot more lines. So in any case, what I did was I secured it with this, held it a little bit, cracked it loose, and then after that, it really does nothing else. Right. So finally done, ran the line up, as you can see, behind. It attached right there. Like I said, it's a little bit more challenging than I expected. But it's an old truck, rusted. As you can see there, the new line. Going right through the channel, straight back. So now I'm gonna bleed the brakes. You start with the one furthest from the master cylinder back there. Once I put the tire on and lower it, car has to be level. And yeah, that's all she wrote. Hopefully this fixes the Jeep. Ready, Bells? You ready? Woo!